nothing, nothing will keep us together.
The build-up was a strange melting pot of emotions.
We can meet them forever and ever.
Nerves blended with tears as start time approached.
We can be heroes just for one day.
Ford and Holden fans united to remember one of the greats and reflect on Friday's horrific crash in the development series. There was a parade of cars Peter Brock raced into the history books, driven by mates and those he mentored.
I will be king.
It was a moving moment before the V8s shook the mountain again. No one could have anticipated what happened next.
It's Brake, Jason Richards, Lowndes, then Greg Murphy and Stephen Richards arguing over the same piece of turf. Then Dean Canto in there behind Russell Engel and Seaton in the top 10 as well. Scaife is in the wall. Scaife's day is done.
Just unbelievable. I mean, I don't think I've ever been to this place where I thought our car performance and our ability to win it was as good.
The car has a fair bit of damage. How about you? I know the Meditrack team's been here to see you. You're okay?
Yeah, I mean, obviously I'm a bit sore, but, you know, I don't think I've ever wanted to win a race so badly. Just unbelievable.
The safety car would need refuelling before the day was over. This was the first of 10 safety car periods. It was an intense race. The pace in the unusually warm conditions was unsustainable. Tyres were pushed to the limit, offering little resistance against debris.
He went off the road, that's why. So what he was talking about, when he said flat, he said, would it be a flat front? Flat spot on the front.
Yeah.
HRT packed up early when Jim Richards crashed out in the 22 car. The other heavyweight factory team, FBR, was in for an early shower. The Sandown winners out after dropping a valve. Most took the opportunity to pit except Craig Lowndes. Strategically, this confused the opposition, but Triple Eight was back in sync during the next safety car period for Stephen Johnson.
Oh, no more trouble up the top of the hill. This time it's car number 17 and it's Stevie Johnson heavily in the wall.
You know, all these years I've tried hard and sort of had pride in myself not to make those sort of mistakes. And, you know, the car was quite twitchy and taily throughout the whole stint. Pretty disappointing, and it's going to be a while before I forgive myself for doing silly stuff like that.
Holden seemed to have the upper hand with Greg Murphy, Cam McConville and the Kelly brothers. Tasman had a puzzling fuel glitch, and Gary Rogers' crew were diving for cover. The hits kept on coming. Paul Radisich, lucky to escape with relatively minor injuries after a head-on with a retaining wall at 140 kilometres an hour. It caused a lengthy delay as crash crews were forced to extract the rat through the roof. The Kelly car duelled with Jamie Wincup and the Stone Brothers Falcons were looming. In the midst of a difficult year, a good result at Bathurst would have been just the tonic for the super cheap team. It wasn't to be.
That wall on the outside just past Skyline very aggressively.
Good job, James Courtney, too. Just missed.
Did he flat spot a tyre, though, in the avoiding manoeuvre?
McConville was a passenger. The off may have been caused by oil on the circuit. Stephen Richards and Paul Dumbrell's Commodore was later ordered to pit to drain an overflowing catch tank. Dean Canto and Lee Holdsworth fell 32 laps short, a heartbreaking end after a gutsy drive. There was a lot to be said for circulating and staying out of trouble. Craig Baird and Jason Barguana finished in the top 10. So did Alex Davison and rookie Grant Denyer. From last to eighth for Paul Wheel and Nathan Pretty. Steve Owen helped Tony Longhurst to a seventh place finish in the Queenslander's final attempt at the great race. Consistency paid off for Paul Morris and Stephen Ellery in sixth. Jason Richards proved that Kiwis really can fly.
What a ride, Jason Richards. Look at this.
Whoa.
Holy smoke.
That is a wild ride at almost 300 kilometres an hour.
Watch the way this car flies. He has the front of mind even straight, not putting any lock on it, and it clear jumps the racetrack before jumping into the beach there.
Power steering problems for the Tasman driver compressed the field for one final seven-lap dash to the flag. Despite a question mark over economy, many thought the HSV dealer team Commodore would have a horsepower advantage. Craig Lowndes had Rick Kelly's measure and the two engaged in a thrilling fight to the flag. A refreshed Russell Engel hunted down a podium as his double-stinting teammate James Courtney fought cramping problems. Ford, finally broke the drought on an incredible day of attrition where only 17 of the 31 starters finished.
And Kelly makes a valiant effort, but he won't have it. It won't be enough. This weekend has been all about farewelling the great man, Peter Brock, the friend and mentor to Craig Lowndes. This will be a huge outpouring of emotion. 10 years in the waiting. Lowndes and Wind Cup do it. That is an incredible
moment. Unbelievable.
And Campbell Little is in tears. You can imagine. And Wind Cup, fist pumping on the wall. Lowndes has done it on the day he farewelled his friend.
There James Courtney and Glenn Seaton will stand on the podium. Glenn's been there before for James Courtney. It's a first time.
Ingle gave it everything he had. And Ingle knows it. It's tight. And Rick Kelly, well done, Rick. Boy, did he fight hard. And Wind Cup gets his first Bathurst crown.
A driver built by Holden in a car powered by Ford. On that emotion-charged Sunday at the mountain, it seemed Tyler Lowndes would be the first to hold the trophy named after his mentor, Peter Brock. Ably backed by Jamie Wincup, who was the perfect co-driver in every sense.
Look at this bloke here. What a superstar. Brought it home. Unbelievably strong at the end. To the Ford fans.
List to everyone out there, thank you very much. As Jamie said, Triple A guys, you are the best. To all the Ford fans here at home, thank you. I've got to personally thank Tom Gorman for allowing me to drive the Tarama rounds this morning because it was a very emotional. It was more about the man himself than manufacturers, but thank you very much. I love yous all. It's great.
The win also extended Lowndes' championship lead to 37 points from Rick Kelly. Holden will now redouble its efforts to claim back the title from Ford. But if Lowndes goes on to win the championship and Bathurst, 2006 will be remembered as a fairy tale year for the driver they used to call the Kid.